Super excited you guys are here. I'm so excited. I'm gonna have to tell my mom about this later. She couldn't make it. She had to find a babysitter, and she tried really hard, but she just couldn't find anyone who wanted to watch her boyfriend. You probably want me to elaborate on that. I don't have much to say. My mom's a cougar. For those of you who didn't notice, I'm short. 4'10" to be exact. And if you can believe it, I was even shorter in high school. I'm going to illustrate my point for you. So, in high school, like I just said, I was even shorter. And I was awkward as fuck. I'm still awkward as fuck. I don't think I can change that much. I haven't evolved. Sorry. I was awkward as fuck. And I used to walk staring at my feet, which if you tried it recently, I don't recommend it. And it was like the parallel opposite to me. His name was Drew. And he was like, I don't know, 6'5", 6'10". He was fucking huge. That's the thing. When you're short, anybody who's taller than you is fucking huge. But this guy was fucking huge. And he was awkward as fuck too, but he did the opposite. He looked at the ceiling when he walked. It's the first day of my senior year. That's important to know. And Drew had just came out of the gym, and he was wearing gym shorts. He'd just done his, I don't know, fucking, I'm going to assume basketball. He was sweaty as fuck, but I didn't know that yet because, like I said, I was looking at my fucking shoes. And we're walking down the hallway, we're going, and all of a sudden we realize we're about to collide, and it's just this awkward scrambling of limbs. And Drew panics, right? And he does this weird leg kick, and I try to dodge it, and that's not what happens. Instead, like this very slow matrix-like thing happens, and I get slapped in the face with this dick. The first day of my senior year is literally a slap in the face, but not just a slap in the face, but a dick slap in the face. I am a 17-year-old virgin getting slapped in the face by a dick on my senior year. And you know what I learned? That is a metaphor for fucking life. They lied to me anyway. So I'm 25 years old. I know I look like I'm 12. Bear with me. And I'm a server. And what I've learned about being a server is that if you thought you were a kind, loving person before, that changes. You realize that you were capable of murder. Any Harry Potter fans out here? Woo! Damn straight. Anyway, so I never understood Voldemort. I felt like he's this real evil guy, and how can he kill all these people? And then I became a server, and I was like, yeah, fuck the Muggles. And I just found myself having all these hateful thoughts, and I channeled it into my alter identity, which is a petty wizard. So if I was a very petty wizard, this is what I do. I didn't finish the song, I'm so sorry. But I curse you guys. And it would be anything really terrible, because I'm not Voldemort, I'm not a murderer. I don't know, I was raised Catholic, so I was raised believing in a heaven and a hell. And I don't know if they're real, but I'm pretty sure if you murder people like your heaven card, it's getting revoked. So I came up with an alternative Russian, and that is petty curses. So now whenever I have a guest who pisses me off, I'm like, may your pillows, each side always be warm. May you pee a little bit every time you sneeze. Some of you, that's probably happening already, sorry. May you get diarrhea every time you talk to a cute member of the opposite sex or the same sex. I don't want to assume things. This is 2017. 2018, shit. Anyway, I have a story about that, actually. Because I'm not great at flirting, and especially not great at people. I really don't know what I'm doing up here. Thank you, guys. So, I was at my friend Becca's bridal shower. It's like, almost like a free, like, how can we get more gifts out of this wedding? Also, is it just me or does like every white girl have a friend named Becca? Or is it Becca? I feel like that's part of the white girl package. Like when you're applying to be a white girl, they're like, oh, and here's your white girl starter kit. It's complete with a weird love for Alanis Morissette, some daddy issues, pumpkin spice lattes, a strange obsession with fall, and a friend named Becca. And that is all it takes. And you can be a basic white girl too. Anyway, so I was at her bridal shower, she discovered that after she found herself. Another thing white girls do, we love to find ourselves. I don't know, it's like a coming out for us. Anyway, so she's vegan, and that's all she served in this bridal shower. She didn't give a fuck about you. That's another thing about vegans. They're heartless. They don't give a shit if you're a carnivore. They want to put that on you. It's like a Jehovah's Witness with a healthier lifestyle. Anyway, so I'm there, and I'm trying, and I'm like, I'm going to be open-minded. I'm going to try her food. And there was this, like, spinach dish that was dairy-free, and it was actually pretty good. I was really feeling it until later. And my IBS kicked in, it was bad. And I knew I wasn't going to make it. And I spent the rest of the bridal shower, I don't mean to be vulgar, but shitting my brains out. It was awful. Like, I'd just be sitting there talking like, Stacy, I'm so interested in your yoga treatment. Could you hold that thought? Dying. I stayed longer than I wanted to, because I wanted to leave. I was going to shake some hands, drop off, and be like, okay, so I hope your marriage doesn't end in divorce. Have a good time. I'm waiting for you to make this decision. Bye. But that's not how it worked out. I had to stay the whole time in the bathroom. Very nice bathroom, by the way. Really nice club, very richly. Shitting my brains out. And I finally felt like I was okay, and that I could leave and just go home, take off my pants, watch Netflix, you know. What adults do. And I get in my car, things are going great, we're cruising, we're moving, we're on 400, and it hits me. That wasn't the war that I finished, that was a battle. The war had just begun. And I was not home yet. The traffic was so bad, and I was like, I thought I had it, like I had a couple near misses, and I was good to go. So I keep cruising along, and it hits me, and I'm not going to make it. At this point, I'm like 10 minutes from home, though, and I'm like, I don't want to stop, because I hate moving in public. I don't know if anyone else feels that way, but it's the fucking worst. Especially in women's bathrooms. Like, people say men's bathrooms are gross. No, women's bathrooms are gross. There's like blood, it's a crime scene. Someone's always changing their baby, it's rough. Is that how you say it? I don't know, kids changing your baby? Anyway, so I feel it coming, and there's a right turn lane, left turn lane, sorry. There's a left turn lane coming up, and I'm like, oh, I'm going to get in that. But there's a light just ahead of it, and I see it turning yellow, and so I just speed the fuck up. I speed as fast as my 1998 Honda Civic can take. But I don't speed fast, and I see lights behind me. And it's the boss. And I get stopped, and I pull over. And in that moment, it's like my body knew that I needed a funny story to tell later, and it betrayed me, and I shit my pants. 25 years old. My kids in a dress. Yeah. And I'm getting pulled over, and I'm covered in my own bodily fluid. And for anybody who's ever been covered, it's not a great place to be. And it gets worse. You're probably wondering, like, how the fuck did that get worse? The most gorgeous man I have ever seen gets out of a police car. He's already in uniform, so that's already like a plus 10 if you're a basic white girl man. And like maybe 20 minutes ago, I would have been hyped, like, hey, officer. No. So I just start crying because what else am I going to do? And he comes over the window, he knocks on the window, and I just go, no. Like, ma'am, I'm going to need you to roll down your window. I'm like, no. So finally I do. And he just goes, and he takes a minute to collect himself, and he's like, so you know why I pulled you over today? And I go, yeah, speeding. And he goes, and you were speeding because I wanted to avoid this. And he goes, so I think you've been punished enough. I'm just gonna let you go home. And I think I'm in the clear, right? I'm like, all right, this day can't get any worse. And so I pull into my driveway, I like fashion a diaper out of my dress, and then my roommate walks out. And he looks at me, and I look at him, and I'm like, just open the door for me, please. And if you need me later, I'll be very busy. That was fun. So I feel like I'm off to a really great start, but I can't wait until I have kids. Because I'm going to tell them to call me dad. I feel like that's the bonus, dad, because you get to fuck with them. That's really, it's really why you have them, in my opinion. Yeah. Anyway, so I can't wait when my kids are in kindergarten, they're talking to other kids, and they're like, oh, you have a mom and a dad? I have two dads. And I'm going to roll up in there with, like, my gorgeous husband, not the cop, obviously. and they're going to be like, so he, post-op, pre-op, what's going on? And I'm like, no, man, I just identify as a dad. Dad Kate. And I'm really excited, too, for when I have grandkids, because then I'm going to be grand happy Kate, and I'm going to be all star. Yeah. Well, thank you, guys. You've been great, obviously.